Now let's talk about case 2, which is of pure shear. So let's take that wedge element forward. We will use here also. There is no sigma acting over here. So you have tau on plane BC and you have tau on plane AB. So you have pure shearing happening. The question here is to find out sigma theta and tau theta due to this tau for the plane AC. Okay. So we will again start with the same technique, that is, we will resolve these two forces in the direction of sigma theta and tau theta. Okay, so we are still assuming that tau theta is up the plane. Right, so let's start with this analysis. Let's first of all resolve this into forces. So this will be tau into BC. Let's take T1, assuming T is equal to 1. Okay, this becomes tau into AB, that becomes a sigma C into AC and tau theta into AC. Right, so let's draw that force distribution again. So this is what? This is tau into AB, right? This is tau, so this is BC, this is not AB, this is BC. BC, this is tau into AB, but horizontal is AB. Okay, let's, so this is tau theta AC, this angle is theta, right? Perpendicular to tau theta you will have sigma theta, so this becomes sigma theta into AC. All right, so this is theta and this is theta. Alright, so let's resolve these forces, these two forces, in the directions of sigma theta and tau theta. So first of all, we will do it for sigma theta. Okay. So it will be, this goes there, so this becomes tau into BC cos theta. And if you bring this down, you will have tau into AB sin theta. Okay. Similarly, if you start for tau theta, so this becomes tau into BC, BC into sin theta. Okay. And this will be resolved in this direction, so you will have tau AB cos theta. So let's first of all write down the expression for sigma theta. So sigma theta AC, so I'll just straight away write down BC upon AC, I'll bring AC onto that side. So this becomes sigma theta is equal to tau into BC upon AC into cos theta plus tau into AB upon AC, tau into AB upon AC into sin theta. Okay, so BC upon AC is what? It is sin theta. AB upon AC is what? Cos theta. So this becomes sin theta cos theta, sin theta cos theta. So this would give you 2 into tau, 2 into tau sin theta cos theta. And sigma theta would then become tau into sin 2 theta. So that is the mathematical formula to find out sigma theta when you only have shearing along the planes AB and plane BC. So this can be put as equation 1. Now let's resolve the forces along tau theta. So you will have tau theta, this is positive, this will become negative, they are taking to the other side, so you will become tau into BC upon AC sin theta minus tau into AB upon AC, AB upon AC into cos theta. Now what is BC upon AC again? BC upon AC is sin theta. So this becomes sin square theta and this becomes cos square theta. So this would be tau into sin square theta minus cos pi theta. Now what is this? This is minus of cos 2 theta. So tau theta, I'll write down here, tau theta would be minus tau cos 2 theta. This means this should be in the downward direction. Okay, so this is equation 2. So this is how you find out the value of sigma theta and the value of tau theta for a case of pure shearing. This is how you do it. Very, very simple. The same technique will carry forward into the next case when we talk about shearing and normal stresses in the planes.